Sir, my name's Fred Rogers, and I wondered if you could tell me how I might find Miss Fleming.
Yeah, straight ahead, right in here.
Oh, thank you very much.
Hi, Fred.
Hi, Peggy.
How are you?
I'm so glad to see you.
Good. It's good to see you, too.
It's wonderful to be able to watch you practice.
Yes, you did catch me right in the middle.
You practice an awful lot, don't you?
Well, I have to keep the muscles really warmed up, and you're always learning new things all the time and perfecting the things that you have known for a long time.
But you started when you were very young, didn't you? About 9 or so.
I started when I was about 9 years old. And I would skate, oh, maybe an hour or two a day when I was a little girl. And then skating is the type of sport that you just learn one thing and then it leads to learning another thing, and it just kind of grows on you.
But did you feel that you had to? I mean, did you feel that somebody was making you practice all the time?
Well, I think I did go through some times like that, but my parents always told me, well, you don't have to go and practice. You really should want to go. And I really did like what I was doing, and that is very important, because you can't devote as much time to a sport like I did if you didn't really love it and enjoy what you were doing. But I'm a wife and mother, and I have other responsibilities than just to devote my life to skating and to my career.
Andrew's 4.
Yes.
4 and a half.
4 and a half years old. Mm-hmm. And he skates a little bit. I started him skating when he was 2. And I basically sort of carried him around and helped him a lot. And he's doing quite well.
I bet he skates a lot better than I do.
I don't know. Do you think you'd like to come out and practice with me?
I would. I brought my skates with me. I can try anyway.
Okay. Well, I'll see you out there in a little while.
All right.
Okay?
I'll put them on. You go around like that.
Well, it's easy. Do you want me to teach you how to do that?
Sure.
I taught Andrew, and he thought that was kind of fun. It's a spin. That's a variation of a very basic thing of twisting around and just letting it go. Spin. And the more tension and the more around this way that you get, and maybe take a little bit of a knee bend and really get it going and let him just go. And then you go faster. Whoa.
That wasn't faster.
That's great. That's really great. And then you can eventually get up to one foot and just do that all on one foot.
Oh, that looks so beautiful. It is very much like the dance, isn't it? No, I don't do the one.
Well, almost.
How do you start with somebody? I mean, what would you say to a person who is just learning to skate?
I always tell them to stick their hands out, because that helps the balance. And your upper body has a lot to do with how you're skating, so that you have to stand up straight. And you do everything in a knee bend. And you just push to the side. And do a crossover like this when you want to go around a corner. That's kind of good. Great.
10 years.
And then to do a skid stop, which you just did naturally. It's sort of like skiing is a lot like skating in some ways because of our blades. It has edges like a ski does, mm-hmm. in a way. And to do a skid stop, I think, just like that, like a snowplow.
Oh.
Sort of just go both feet. You're just a natural, Fred. You really are.
I love to try, but it's been such a long... Oh, that made me go backward.
Uh-huh. Just go like that.
Does Andrew do all that?
Mm-hmm.
You must be so proud of him.
I am. I really am. He's just a real joy.
But it's not all practice, is it? Some of it just...
No, sometimes we go out and we just play. Play tag on the ice, or he sometimes, when nobody's looking, he comes out with his Hot Wheels, and he drives his Hot Wheels all around the rink.
Do you follow him?
Oh no, I try to stay away from him, and he does turns, because he can put his brakes on, and that makes him do spins, which he can't do on the driveway, but he can do on the ice. So the ice is fun, too.
Do you have any pictures of Andrew?
I do. I always carry pictures of my little boy.
I'd like to see them. Could
yeah,
I?
I'd love to show them to you.
Where are they?
I think they're in my bag.
Okay. Thank you for giving me extra confidence.
Oh, you're welcome.
Is this where it is?
Yes, this is my bag. I think they're in here somewhere. Oh, there they are.
Oh.
It was him at the beach last summer.
He's feeling very strong, isn't he?
I think so. Yeah. I think he was a muscle man. That's him right after coming from the beach, and he was looking outside and going, oh, that was so much fun, and he had so much sun and sand and a lot of fun. And that's some of my favorite pictures of him.
Any wonder you're proud of this boy.
I am.
And I'm sure he's proud of his mom.
I think he is. That was really fun skating with you.
Thanks
you did
for
so
today.
Well. It was fun.
Well, you make me feel... able to do it. You
well,
know, that's
good.
Something about a teacher.
Really?
She helps you feel as if you can, and then you keep trying.
That's very true. Well, I have to get ready to go do the show.
Thank you, Peggy. I've got to get back
together.
To my television house, too.
Okay. It was real fun.
Thanks so
good
much.
To see you.
I love
to
meeting
see
you
again.
And my love to Andrew, too.
Okay. I will. Bye-bye.
Bye, my dear. She's certainly a lovely person.
Yes, she is.
Thank you so much for all your help.
Oh, you're welcome.
See you. Bye-bye.
Goodbye.